Everybody, what's up and welcome back to my channel. So in today's video, I'm back with another product review, and I have actually done a product review before for this company, and I'm really excited about this one. But before I tell you what it is, make sure you hit the red subscribe button down below and turn on my post notifications so you can be notified every time I upload a brand new video. For Creative Girls Club, and this one is a Boho Dream Catcher, and I've actually always wanted a dream catcher, so I'm really excited that I got this, and I cannot wait to make it. It looks difficult, but I think I can do it. Okay, so let's open it. I don't need that. Okay, so first, this is the instructions. So we're definitely gonna need these. Let's get all of the pieces out. Whoa. I feel like those pins. So I have everything out. I love the colors. So I have everything out. Now we just need to read the instructions and see what's first. Okay, so it comes with a wood ring, some yarn, and I love the colors. It's blue, green, and purple. Ribbon. Hemp cord and feathers. You will also need scissors, ruler, pencil, glue, and a yarn needle is optional. Number one says, with the ruler, mark a starting point on the ring. So I'm gonna put my ruler right here and then mark it. Just like this. Number two says, measure 6 1/4 inches and make another mark. Repeat one more time. It's a good thing my ruler is bendy and flexible. Now that I have the ring marked, let's move on to step three. Number three says, starting with purple yarn, wrap the yarn around one of the marks on the ring and tie a knot, leaving a 3-inch tail. Note, let the yarn tail hang loose. Okay, so purple yarn. Now I'm going to tie a knot. I tied my knot. Step four says wrap the yarn tightly around the ring until you get to the next mark on the ring. And now I have all of it wrapped. So step number five, you're going to need your blue yarn, and it says tie the blue yarn to the end of the purple yarn. Tuck the yarn tails in as you continue wrapping around the ring. So now you're going to take your blue and wrap it all the way around, but first you want to hold your tails right here. You want to hold them down, and then you're going to wrap the blue cord around them, so then you won't see them anymore. All the blue wraps, I'm going to do the exact same thing with the green. So here is what my ring looks like with all of the yarn on it, and I just tied the purple and green together to make a knot at the end, and now I'm going to cut it down as much as possible. Create the inside of the dream catcher. I feel like this might be the trickiest part out of the whole thing, but hopefully I can do it. But the first step is tie one end of rainbow cord to wrapped ring in a double knot. So take my rainbow cord, that, and then we're gonna tie it onto this. Okay, so it is in a knot. So the next step is loosely loop cord 17 times around ring. Note, space the loops as evenly as possible around the ring. And now I wrap my rainbow cord all the way around it. And now step three says, once you're at the knot, start looping the cord through the first row of loops. Every few loops, pull the cord tight. Okay, I'm gonna try this. Okay guys, so this was a lot harder than I thought. So I actually had my mom make it, and it is not quite like the picture was, but I still think it looks really cool. So now we have to decorate it with our feathers and ribbon. So now you're gonna take your blue, green, and purple ribbon, and you're going to cut them in half. Okay, so number three says, using the 18-inch lengths of flatter yarn, tie the feather onto the bottom of the ring. Place a drop of glue on each knot to secure the feather. Okay, so just putting all of these feathers in ribbon on, and for some reason, mine did not come with a blue feather. There's supposed to be a big blue feather right down the middle, but mine didn't come with it. I don't know why, but here is the finished product. I think it looks really pretty. I really like it. So I want to thank Creative Girls Club for sending me this awesome kit. If you guys want to get your own, I will leave their link down below. And so that is all that I have for you guys today. Question of the day is going to be, have you ever had a dream catcher, or have you ever made a dream catcher? I have never had a dream catcher, and this was my first time at making one, and I'm really excited. I was so excited when I got it. I was like, oh my gosh, a dream catcher. So don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Make sure to leave a comment down below and subscribe, and I'll see you guys tomorrow. Bye!